إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها فكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is truly worthy of all praise. To Allah belongs the most beautiful names and attributes of complete perfection. And indeed all thanks is due to Allah, the one who is the source of all blessings. And peace and salutations upon the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent as a mercy to all of the alameen. Dear brothers and sisters, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the earth. And when He created the earth, He chose from the portion of the earth which His wisdom dictated and gave it a status and dubbed it Balad al-Haram or Balad al-Amin, out of all of the places of the earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the seven heavens and chose the seventh of them to be beneath His throne and His chair. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created paradise. And there are many levels. And He made the highest of them al-Firdaus. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the angels. And amongst the angels He gave some of those angels a unique status. Jibreel alayhi salam, Mikael alayhi salam, and Israfil alayhi salam. Jibreel alayhi salam was given the most highest of honor, and that he was the one who would convey the words of Allah to the messengers of Allah upon the earth. And he levied upon Mikael the responsibility for the rain, which brings life to the earth. And Israfil, who is given the task that he announces the Qiyamah. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the souls. And then from amongst the souls, He chose the best of the souls to be the prophets. And when He created the prophets, from amongst the prophets, He created the five greatest messengers. And from those five greatest messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from them chose Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon whom He revealed the Quran, and who succeeded all of the prophets to be the final prophet and messenger to come upon the earth. Brothers and sisters, some of the brothers asked if one of these Jum'ahs we could discuss the life and death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him honor. And subhanAllah, what more beautiful speech than to speak about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who is more worthy that we should sit in his presence. And that, of course, allegorically, that we cannot sit in his real presence. But through the history of the Prophet ﷺ, to meet him and to know him. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him out of all of the prophets. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him that he became Sayyid al-Mursaleen, the leader of the messengers, and Khatib al-Anbiya, the seal of the prophets, and the Sayyid, or the leader of the children of Adam alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose him to be the sahib al-hawd, the one who will be given the fount, and the sahib al-shafa' al-kubra, the one who will be given the meritorious act of being the intercessor for mankind. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him all of this. Those are the matters of the Akhirah as well as the dunya. Look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him perfect. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu. He chose him and preferred him and gave him attributes unlike the other humans. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu fi aqli. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about how he purified his aql. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Najm, وَمَا ظَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا غَوَى. Nor did your companion go astray, nor did he err. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu in every matter, in his sidq, that he was truthful in his claim. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Nor does he speak of his own desires. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu in his knowledge. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, عَلَّمَهُ شَدِيدُ الْقُوَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angel Jibreel to teach him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu fi basari. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purified him in his sight. Hence Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ وَمَا طَغَى. Nor did his eyesight go astray. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu fi fu'adi, in his heart. مَا كَذَبَ الْفُعَادُ مَا رَعَى. And his heart did not lie about that which he saw. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu fi sadri. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also purified his chest. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. Did we not open your breast? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu, subhanAllah, in his khuluq. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And indeed you are upon a very great character. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala zakkahu fi dhikri. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purified him in his remembrance. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ الْذِكْرَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him his remembrance. Indeed, he is the Habib of Allah, the beloved of Allah, and the Khalil of Allah, and the most honored of all of the creation of Allah in the sight of Allah. Indeed, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he anointed the prophets, he took from them a pledge. And this pledge was that they would believe in him and that they would aid him and bring him victory. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Imran concerning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the pledge that he took from the of the prophets concerning him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ. And when your Lord took from the prophets, from his prophets, a pledge. What was the pledge? لَمَا آتَيْتُكُمْ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ. When I gave you the book and the wisdom. ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ. And then there comes to you a messenger. مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ. And that messenger will verify that which has come to you. He will verify the message which Allah has sent you previously. What will you do? لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ. You will believe in him. The Anbiya are ordered, whilst they preceded him, that they should believe in him. وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّ. And that you will aid him in his mission and give him victory. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ أَقْرَرْتُمْ. Do you accept that and verify that وأخرتم على ذلك مصري, and you have given your pledge, firm pledge to Allah. The Anbiya said, قالوا أقررنا. We have accepted that pledge. We have given you, Allah, that pledge. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فاشهدوا. Then bear witness, وأنا معكم من الشاهدين. And I am with you amongst those who bear witness. They bore witness that they would believe in him and in him. And this is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when he was sitting in the presence of Umar, or Umar was sitting in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiallahu anhu, and he was reading from the pages of the Torah, and the Prophet became angry, and his anger would be known for the color in his face. He would turn red. And the other companion said, oh Umar, do you not see that the Prophet has become angry? So Umar radiallahu anhu threw aside the pages of the Torah. And he bore witness that the Prophet Muhammad is the final messenger and his prophet. And then the Prophet said to him, do you know, Umar, if Musa was alive today, he would have no other course of action except to believe in me and follow me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet merit over the little prophets. Some of those things Allah's messengers have mentioned them. The hadith which is narrated on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu in Sahih Muslim and At-Tirmidhi and all the books of hadith. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَضِلْتُ عَلَى الْأَنْبِيَاءِ بِسِتِّينَ, I have been given merit over the prophets with six things. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listed them. أُعْطِيتُ جَوَانَ الْكَلِمِ, I have been given this special speech, which the Prophet called Jawab al-Kalim. Jawab al-Kalim means to say a statement with only a few words, and for that to have then such a vast meaning, he was given concise speech. And the Prophet said, وَنُسُنْتُ بِرَوْبٍ. Another narration he mentions, in the narration in Bukhari, مَسِيرَةَ جَهَرٍ, I have been given victory with a fear and an awe which Allah puts in the hearts of my enemies. The narration which is mentioned in Bukhari mentions that that is even a distance of a month's travel. They have this fear in the heart of the Prophet. And the Prophet said, وَأُحِلَّتْ لِي الْغَنَائِمِ, and it has been made lawful for me to take the war booty. And the Prophet said, وَجُعِلَتْ لِي الْأَرْضُ مَسْجِدًا وَطَهُورًا, and the whole of the earth has been made purification for me and a place of prayer. And Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَخُتِمَ بِي النَّبِيُّونَ, and with me there has come to a succession the prophets. There will be no other prophets after me. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sent prophets and messengers, he gave them a status as he saw fit. And when it came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam this great status. That in the hadith which is mentioned in Bukhari and Muslim and Abu Dawud and Ahmad, on the authority of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, the narration is authentic, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described himself. He said, "Inna mithli wa mithlul anbiya min qabli." He said, "My likeness and the likeness of the anbiya or the prophets that were before me." كَمَثَلِ رَجُلٍ بَنَى بُنْيَانًا فَأَحْسَنَهُ وَأَجْمَلَهُ. It's like the man who built a building, and he made this building good and beautiful. He really exceeded himself in this building. And then the Prophet said, إِلَّا مَوْضِعِ لَبَنَةٍ, except for one portion, one brick, مِنْ زَاوِيَةٍ مِنْ زَوَايَا, from one of the sides, one brick was missing. فَجَعَلَ النَّاسِ يَطُوفُونَ بِهِ وَيَعْجَبُونَ بِهِ. So the people came, and they began to look at this building, and they began to marvel at how well it was built. Except this one portion, the brick which is missing. The Prophet ﷺ said, هَلَّا وُضِعَتْ هَذِي اللَّبْنَ. If only this one brick was placed in its appropriate place, then the Prophet ﷺ said, فَأَنَا اللَّبْنَ وَأَنَا خَاتَمُ النَّبِيِّينَ. The Prophet ﷺ said, I am this one brick, and I am the seal of the Prophets, the last of the Prophets. Indeed, the Prophet ﷺ said, the hadith which they written in Bukhari and Muslim, and Abu Dawud and Ahmad, on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet ﷺ said, Ana Sayyidu Walad Adam, I am the leader or the chief of the children of Adam, Yawm al-Qiyam, on the Day of Judgment. Wa ana awwalu man yunshaqu anhu al-qabr, and I am the first of whom, for whom the grave will be opened. Wa awwalu shafin wa awwalu mushaffa'in, I will be the first to be given intercession, and the first whose intercession will be accepted. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam adds to this on the Day of Judgment, when the difficulties of the Qiyamah will only become too real. We read of them today, but how vivid they will be when we will see them with our own eyes. And on that day, all of the people, they will find that the sun will come close to their heads, from which the heat of that will cause them to boil. And as the Prophet also mentioned, the Jahannam will be brought close. It's narrated in Bukhari, in Muslim, again on the authority of one of his companions, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. He says that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Yu'ta bi Jahannam." The Jahannam will be brought out. Laha sab'una alfa zimam. It will have 70,000 reins by which it will be pulled. Ma kulli zamamin sab'una alf malik yajurruha. With every one of these reins will be 70,000 angels who will be dragging the Jahannam. This is the Day of Judgment. Imagine when the Jahannam is brought out like that, how the eyes will stare in terror. When the children of Adam, when they will see the Jahannam and its flames, and they will know that day the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all of the creation will be brought together on one plane, standing, their feet not moving. Can you imagine the awe and the terror? And on that day, because of this awe and terror, because the Jahannam will be brought out, and the sun will be brought close, and the people will come to realize that their appointed time and their reckoning with Allah is close at hand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَرَى كُلَّ أُمَّةٍ جَهْفِيَةٍ. Because of the long standing on the plain where the creation will be brought together, every nation will fall to their knees. On this day, all of the Jababira and the Maluk will buckle at their knees and fall on their knees. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you will see kullu ummatin jathiya. Every nation, you will see them fall to their knees, because their legs will not carry them. For the awe and terror of that day, on that day, as narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, and Ahmad, in other books of hadith, on the authority of Sayyidina Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Ana Sayyidun Nas Yawm al-Qiyam. I will be the chief of all of mankind on the Day of Qiyamah. Wa hal tadruna mimma dhalik? And then he asked, will you know why that is? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring together the first and the last of us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the first and the last of us, and Adam alayhi salam will be brought, and the people will come to Adam alayhi salam, and they will say to him, Ya Adam, Anta Abu Bashar. O Adam, you the father of mankind. خلقك الله بيده ونفخ فيك من روحه وأمر الملائكة فسجدوا لك. They will come to Adam عليه السلام and they will mention to him the merits which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. So they will say, O Adam, you are the father of all of mankind. Adam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you with his own hands and blew into you from his spirit. And he ordered the angels to prostrate to you. They will say, فَشْفَعْ لَنَا إِلَىٰ Intercede on our behalf to your Lord. All of these merits that were mentioned, why? Because when somebody has merit, that merit is then warranted for them that they can go forward and speak on somebody else's behalf. So they will say, intercede on our behalf to your Lord. And he will say, Allah tara ma nahnu fi. They will say to him, do you not see the difficulty in which we are this moment? Allah tara ila ma qad balagna. You will see, do you not see where we have now arrived at? And he will say to them, فَيَقُولُ آدَمُ Adam alayhi salam will say to them, إِنَّ رَبِّي غَضَبَ الْيَوْمَ غَضَبًا لَمْ يَغْضَبْ قَبْلَهُ مِثْلَهُ وَلَنْ يَغْضَبْ بَعْدَهُ مِثْلَهُ He will say, indeed my Lord, this day is so angry. Never has he been this angry before this day. And never will he be as angry as he is today, ever again. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be so angry. And then he will say, SubhanAllah, look at the righteousness of Allah. He will say, وَإِنَّهُ نَهَانِ الشَّجْرَ فَأَصَيْتُ He forbade me. He forbade me to eat from the tree. And I disobeyed. And I disobeyed. Then he will say, Nafsi, Nafsi, Nafsi. He will be afraid for himself. And then he will say to them, Idhabu ila ghayri. Go to another person. And then he will advise them, idhabu ila Nuh. Go to Nuh alayhi salam. فَيَأْتُونَ نُوحًا So they will come to Nuh alayhi salam, فَيَقُولُونَ And they will say, يَا نُوحُ أَنْتَ أَوَّلُ الرُّسُلُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِ الْأَرْضِ O Nuh, you are the first of the messengers to the earth. وَسَمَّاكَ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has dubbed you his slave. عَبْدًا شَكُورًا His thankful slave, grateful slave. And they will say, فَاشْفَعْ لَنَا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ أَلَا تَرَى مَا نَحْنُ فِيهِ They will say to him, intercede on our behalf to your Lord. Do you not see the difficulty that we are in? أَلَا تَرَى مَا قَدْ بَلَغَنَا Do you not see what we have arrived at? And Nuh alayhi salam will reply, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَدْ غَضَبَ الْيَوْمُ غَضَبًا لَمْ يَغْضَبْ قَبْلَهُ مِثْلَهُ وَلَنْ يَغْضَبْ بَعْدَهُ مِثْلَهُ He will say, just like Adam alayhi salam who preceded him. He will say to him, my Lord today is so angry. Never has he been as angry as this before this. And never will he be as angry as this again. And then he will say, وَإِنْ كَانَتْ لِي دَعْوَةٌ دَعْوَةُ بِهَا عَلَىٰ قَوْمِ نَفْسِ He said that indeed, I have a dua which I made for my people. And then he will say, Nafsi, Nafsi. He will complain about himself. And then he will say to them, Idhabu ila ghayri. Go to another beside me. So he will say, Fayatuna Ibrahim. He will say, Good Ibrahim, they will come to Ibrahim alayhi salam. And they will say, Ya Ibrahim, anta nabiyullah wa khaliluhu min ahli al-ardi. Ala tara ma nahnu fihi. Ala tara ila ma qad balagna. They will say to him, You, O Ibrahim, are the Prophet of Allah and his close companion. Do you not see the anguish that we are in? Do you not see the difficulty that we have arrived at? For he will say to them, Inna Rabbi ghadab al-yawma ghadaban. What comes to mind here? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most merciful, but on that day, he'll be most angry. What will be the status of those people who today sell to people the ticket to paradise? Physically, they are telling people they have the ticket to paradise, and they sell it with money. Beyond belief! When the Anbiya of Allah, their hal is like this. When Ibrahim Khalilullah, he will say to the people that I told, or I made speech which apparent of it was that they were falsehoods. And then he will say to the people, go to other than him. And he will say, go to Musa alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam will say, Inna Rabbi qad ghadab al-yawma ghadaban lam yaghdab mithl dhalik. My Lord today is so angry, never has been this angry. وَلَنْ يَغْضَبْ بَعْدَهُ مِثْلُ. And never will he be as angry as this after this. And then he will say, وَإِنِّي قَتَلْتُ نَفْسًا. The Anbiya of Allah, who stood against their nations, who stood against the world for Allah's sake. And Allah sent them revelation, and they received books, and Allah helped them with his signs. On that day, they will surrender. They will surrender. Musa alayhi salam will say that I killed a soul, and I was not ordered to kill this soul. And he will say, go to other than me. And so he will advise them, go to Isa alayhi salam. And likewise, Isa alayhi salam, they will mention his merit. They will say, Anta Rasulullah, you are the messenger of Allah. Wa kalimatuhu alqaha ala Maryam wa ruhun minhu. You are the messenger of Allah. And you are the word of Allah which he cast upon Maryam. And you are a spirit from him. They will mention his merit. And then they will say, وَكَلَّمْتَ النَّاسِ بِالْمَهَدِ. And you spoke to the people from the cradle. Then they will say, intercede on our behalf. Do you not see the difficulty that we are in? And what difficulty we have arrived at? So Isa alayhi salam will say to them, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَدْ غَضَبَ الْيَوْمَ غَضَبًا لَمْ يَغْضَبْ مِثْلُهُ وَلَنْ يَغْضَبْ بَعْدَ مِثْلُهُ. My Lord today is so angry. Never has he been before this been as angry as this, and never will he after this be as angry as this. And then he will say to them that the people, they said things concerning me, but doesn't mention any sin. And then he will say, Nafsi, Nafsi. Myself, myself. And then he will say to them, Idhabu ila Muhammad. Go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fayatun. So the people will come. Fayakuluna ya Muhammad, anta Rasulullah. They will say, Muhammad, you are the messenger of Allah. Wa khatul anbiya. And you are the seal of the prophets. Wa ghafar Allah laka ma taqadama min dhanbika wa ma ta'akhkhar. And Allah has forgiven you your future sins and your past sins. And then they will say, فَشْفَعْ لَنَا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. So therefore, intercede on our behalf to your Lord. Do you not see what difficulty we are in? And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, فَأَقُومُ. So I will stand. فَآتِي تَحْتَ الْأَرْضِ. So I will come and be present. فَأَقَعُ سَاجِدًا لِرَبِّي عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. And I will fall prostrate for my Lord Most High. ثم يفتح الله علي ويلهمني من محامده وحسن الثناء عليه ما لم يفتحه على أحد قبلي. سبحان الله. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal to me through ilham words of praise and glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has never been given to anybody before me. Whilst I am prostrating. Look at the Rabb and look at the Abd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then, as the Prophet say, Ya Muhammad, irfa ra's. O Muhammad, raise your head. Sal tu'fa. Ask, you will be given. Ishfa' tushfa'. Intercede. And your intercession will be heard. فَأَقُولُ سُبْحَانَ. How arduous is this man? The Prophet ﷺ will say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabbi, Ummati, Ummati. The Prophet ﷺ will say, Oh my Lord, my Ummah, my Ummah. SubhanAllah, can you imagine our meeting with the Prophet ﷺ? Inshallah, the believers will see him before this time when they will come looking for water to drink. Can you imagine meeting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the hawl? Those who will be given the opportunity to meet him. And there will be those who won't get the opportunity to meet him. Because they rejected him and his sunnah. And they took the religion as jest. And they did as they pleased rather than as he ordered. Nowadays you tell the people, the Prophet did this or said this. They say, what new religion have you come with? Never did we hear this from our forefathers. It's the same story that we hear of the nations before this. When the prophets came to them and advised them, and they said, never did we hear this from our forefathers. And Allah says, even though their forefathers were in manifest error, just like our forefathers were in manifest error. A time has come to this ummah when we didn't learn this religion that Allah revealed to us. And we didn't open the book of Allah to understand it. We took it instead as just symbols. Yes, we walk into the court and swear by the book of Allah and then we tell utter lies. That's what the book of Allah has been reduced to. We don't turn our back on it and put it in the highest shelves and we wrap it in the most luxurious cloth. And when we rest it on the most beautiful scented woods. But when we are given the message of the Quran, what then? What then? The Quran forbade us, but we made it lawful. The Quran ordered us and it fell upon deaf ears. That's what we did with the book of Allah. That's what we did with the book of Allah. Can you imagine meeting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How embarrassing it would be that we called ourselves from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and this was our hal. This is our power. Imagine now, the way you look, if you met the Prophet ﷺ, would it be a point of embarrassment for you? When Allah's Messenger ﷺ would look at your madhar, your appearance, do you think he would be proud of us? Many of us, he will not even want to look at us. Perhaps he would turn away from us. When he would look at our actions, do you think he would be proud to say, this man is from my ummah? brothers and sisters. Who will the Prophet make shafa'a for? Doesn't take any rocket scientist to work this out. We are foolish to believe that we are all deserving of the shafa'a of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, the Prophet will be given shafa'a. And who he makes shafa'a for will be successful. And his shafa'a will be heard. And Allah will order it to be. But who are you that he should make shafa'a for you? Alas, when we find ourselves asking this question, we should all ask ourselves this question. Will I be given the shafa'a of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him as a mercy to the all of the alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Rahmah when he came to the dunya, and rahmah in the akhirah. Brothers and sisters, the khutbah of today was supposed to be the death of the Prophet ﷺ. But instead we talked about the life and the mercy and the status of the Prophet ﷺ. Because this mawqif warrants it. When we have heard how great he is, only then we will come to realize how his death was a loss. As some of the righteous people in the past, they said that the greatest musibah, the greatest calamity to befall the Muslims was the death of the Prophet ﷺ. If you look at today, Muslims are being massacred, wars are being waged against them, bombs are dropped from the skies, and women and children and innocent people are being killed. You would say this is a calamity. But all of those calamities, they are minuscule in front of this calamity, the death of the Prophet ﷺ. I hope inshallah that next week, if Allah gives us life, we will discuss the death of the Prophet ﷺ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us a people who may hear the truth, let us be true, give us the ability to act upon it. And also make us a people who may hear the false, let us be false, and give us the ability to avoid it. وأقول ما تسمعون. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ما بعد أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى في السر والعلن وصلوا وسلموا على البشير النذير فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد أمركم بذلك في كتابه فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي مرة واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم أربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر أصحاب نبيك أجمعين وعن أهل بيت الطيبين الطاهرين وارض اللهم عنا معهم بمنك وكرمك وجودك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين واحمي حوزة الإسلام يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء من والأموات عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تسمعون فأقيموا الصلاة